The following presentation for the 10-year anniversary of Hurricane Charley is a public service announcement from the Tampa Bay Area, Florida National Weather Service Office. This video focuses on the history of the storm. Hurricane Charley was a small but powerful hurricane that made landfall on August 13, 2004 at around 3:45 p.m. near Cayo Costa, a barrier island in southwest Florida. It then moved onshore of mainland Florida in Punta Gorda around 4:45 p.m. Charley rapidly intensified just before making landfall as a Category 4 hurricane. Charley began as a tropical storm in the Southeast Caribbean Sea on August 10, 2004, moving on a northwestward track. It then strengthened into a hurricane before turning north and crossing Cuba early on August 13th. Charley then moved quickly to the north and northeast, making landfall again on the 13th in southwest Florida at 3:45 p.m. Charley crossed the state in about 8 hours and impacted numerous inland cities along its path, such as Arcadia, Zolfo Springs, Fort Meade, and Orlando, before exiting the state near Daytona Beach around 11:30 p.m. Charley's forecasted track in the days prior to landfall lifted the storm north off of Cuba and paralleled the West Florida coastline before turning northeast. This put much of Florida's west coast at risk for potential impacts, and much of the state went under the cone of uncertainty about 4 days prior to landfall. Everyone started taking precautions, and as the storm drew closer, hurricane watches were issued nearly 35 hours prior to landfall for the entire west coast of Florida, from the Keys north to the Suwannee River. Those were upgraded to hurricane warnings almost 23 hours prior to landfall. A slight eastward shift in the track about 3 hours before landfall put the focus on southwest Florida. Meteorologists at your National Weather Service in Ruskin, as well as others across the state at other local forecast offices, and across the nation at national centers, were constantly monitoring conditions through radar, satellite, and observations as Charley moved through the area. We were also continuously updating forecasts and warnings before, during, and after the event. At the same time, our partners in the media were also hard at work, keeping viewers at home updated with those changes, as well as relaying the latest advisories from local public officials and emergency managers regarding things like evacuation orders and shelter openings. Charley was a compact but powerful hurricane. It caused 10 fatalities in the U.S. and over $15 billion in damages, ranking it the eighth costliest storm to date. The narrow wind field with Charley kept storm surge relatively low at 6 to 7 feet, and the majority of damage within a 10-mile swath from the center of the storm. Damage within that swath was extensive, however, leveling some communities and even cutting a several hundred-yard-wide channel across North Captiva Island. This video is part of a series produced by the National Weather Service Tampa Bay Area, Florida office in honor of the 10th anniversary of Hurricane Charley. For more information or to view the rest of the series, please visit one of the websites shown. A special thank you goes out to the St. Petersburg Times and its affiliates for use of the newspaper clips, and to Jim Farrell and Wink TV for use of the video clip.